Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation Lecture Series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you maximum usable frequency. In short, it is even referred as MUF in this session. So what is maximum usable frequency in sky wave propagation and how to measure it? So that is what we are dealing with to discuss by this outlines. Where first, I'll give you a basic definition of maximum usable frequency. After that, we will see physical understanding, which is there with maximum usable frequency. So how it is happening and how to understand all those things. So that is what I'll explain by physical understanding. And then after, we will see derivation of maximum usable frequency. And after that, I'll give you some key points which we need to take care of when we see maximum usable frequency in sky wave propagation. So let us begin this session with first point, that is definition of maximum usable frequency. Now see, maximum usable frequency is defined as highest frequency that can be used for sky wave communication between two given points on Earth. So when we have two points, one is transmitter and one is receiver, at that time in sky wave propagation, all we do is we send signal in the sky, and from ionospheric layer, signal will get reflected back to the receiver. And here we keeps on increasing frequency at transmitter side, and we see whether signal is received at receiver or not. And at maximum frequency, till receiver receives signal, we can say that frequency is maximum usable frequency. So let us try to understand that by physical understanding, so it will be more clear. Now see here, this is the Earth which we have, and at one position there is a transmitter, and at second position there is a receiver. And in sky wave propagation, here we have ionospheric layer, and we send signal from transmitter to ionospheric layer, and from layer that signal will get reflected back to receiver. Now here our agenda is to increase frequency continuously, and we need to increase this frequency till this receiver receives. At some frequency you will be finding receiver will not receive that signal, so there is a possibility that the signal will go in space somewhere, right? So here in maximum usable frequency, we need to understand this, like see, up to some frequency only that signal will come back to the receiver, and that is what maximum usable frequency. So here we keeps on increasing frequency at transmitter till receiver receives the signal, and we find maximum frequency up to which we receive signal, and that is what maximum usable frequency. Now let us derive maximum usable frequency first. So this is what the case which I have already explained regarding sky wave propagation, where for ionospheric layer, this formula that we have already derived in my previous session, where refractive index, that is sine theta I divided by sine theta, where this theta is incident angle, and this theta, that is angle at which the signal is getting reflected to the Earth from ionospheric layer. And see, all those parameters that I have already placed here in this formula, where n is refractive index, theta is angle of incident. So see, this is what angle of incident, right? Then n is number density, f is frequency at which we send signal. So theta, that is angle at which signal is getting reflected from ionospheric layer. So you can see this is a theta. So here we do reflection from the ionospheric layer, and maximum value of theta can be 90 degree. You cannot have theta more than 90 degree, right? Now, by using this formula, we will derive this maximum usable frequency. So from the given equation, we can say, see, n is equals to theta I by sine theta, where theta can be 90 degree at most. So if I place theta is equals to 90 degree, sine 90 will be 1. So we can say sine theta incident angle is equals to square root of 1 minus 81n divided by f square. Now I have already explained critical frequency, and critical frequency, that is square root of 81n. So if we place that in this, then you will be finding 81n that will be fc square. So see, sine theta I is equals to square root of 1 minus fc square by f, where fc is critical frequency. Now further, if we simplify this equation, then sine square theta I is equals to 1 minus fc square by f
square.
And if I take this 1 over this side, then 1 minus sine square theta, that will become cos square theta, and cos square theta incident angle, that will be equals to fc square by f
square,
where f is maximum usable frequency as theta is 90 degree at most. So from this we can say f is equals to fc divided by cos theta I. So f is fc divided by cos theta I, and this is fc divided by cos theta I, that is maximum usable frequency. Now let us try to understand some key points. So see, as I have derived, maximum usable frequency is critical frequency divided by cos theta I, right? But there are few important points that we need to note down. See, as per the rule of thumb, maximum usable frequency is approximately 3 times that of critical frequency. So you'll be finding this maximum usable frequency is approximately 3 times. It is varying with respect to incident angle, but usually you'll be finding it is almost 3 times compared to critical frequency in most of the scenarios. So this is what average case which we have considered over here. On a given day, communication may not happen at maximum usable frequency. So optimum frequency is selected or estimated based on bit lower frequency, right? So what we do is we estimate optimum frequency at 80 to 90% of maximum usable frequency. So we don't communicate with maximum usable frequency in between transmitter and receiver, but all we do is we decrease the frequency by this fraction. Like on an average, we consider 85% of maximum usable frequency is optimum frequency. So to avoid irregularity of atmosphere, we use optimum usable frequency, and it is given by optimum usable frequency is 0.85, means 85% of maximum usable frequency. So that will be 0.85 into fc divided by cos theta I. So optimum usable frequency, that is what the case which we use it in communication for sky wave propagation, where we have proper communication without having any ambiguities, and we can avoid irregularities of atmosphere. As we know, atmospheric parameter changes with respect to daytime, as well as atmospheric parameter changes with respect to season, and those irregularities that can be avoided by lowering maximum usable frequency by 85%, and that is what optimum usable frequency. So this is how we communicate in sky wave propagation. I hope that you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely, based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will help you out to understand all those things which I'm teaching here. And you can download all these things which I'm teaching here from my Android application Engineering Funda. And link of application is given in description of all videos, so you can download it from there. And in Play Store even, you can write Engineering Funda. Definitely you will get my application there, and you'll be finding many subjects material that I have placed it free of cost. So without cost, you can download all those things, and I hope that will gives you some benefit. And in future even many more things will come. So please give your valuable support, please give your suggestions, and those suggestions are helping so many students, those who are learning from my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.